people, in this video, we want to look at malignant melanoma, or you can just say melanoma. We want to look at melanoma. Okay. So basically, this is skin, right? Now in skin, you know the layers. You have stratum germinatum or stratum basale, in which you have these melanocytes sitting, right? In the basal cell layer, you have the melanocytes sitting, right? In the skin, in the epidermis. So basically, these melanocytes can undergo mutation, or they may undergo proliferation and cause this melanoma. Okay. So basically, they are arising from melanocytes. This melanoma is a malignant condition arising from the melanocytes. This can be not just the skin. It can even happen in the oral cavity, in the anogenital region, esophagus, conjunctiva. Imagine conjunctival malignant melanoma is there. Vulva malignant melanoma is there. Okay. So many types of melanomas are there. Okay. Can you imagine even in the leptomeninges, arachnoid and pia mater, even in the neuro, you will study this even in the intracranial tumors. Okay. So malignant melanoma. In skin, the common sites are trunk in men and the legs in women. Okay. So that is about the skin. Moving on. So basically in skin you have something called as a nevus. Okay. N-A-E-V-U-S. Nevus means mole. This is a nevus. This is a nevi. Okay. This is a benign condition. And this is malignant melanoma, which is, this is a malignant condition. So basically any mole, nevus, it is a benign condition. It does not cause any harm. But this is a malignant condition. You can see that very typically you can see it's asymmetric, very irregular margins, and the color is also not same, right? It is very varying color. So all these are the features of a malignant melanoma. Okay. So basically you should write this in the exam. Nevus, N-A-E-V-U-S, nevus and malignant melanoma. Okay. So basically, why does this melanoma or malignancy happen? Guys, what are we discussing today? Today we are discussing what? Malignant melanoma. So you have looked at a word called nevus. That is nothing but a mole. This is a benign condition. Benign, usually this is a harmless people. If they have by before itself from birth, if these moles are there, it's fine. But anything that appears new and their features are like asymmetry, etc., there can be a melanoma, which is a malignant condition. Right? This is a malignant condition. Okay. So going back here, so why do people get it? If white skin people are exposed excess to sunlight, so you should write here UV light. Okay, UV rays can cause this. Then family history of melanoma, age of the patient. If patient ages more, right, you'll have to say all this: white skin, sunlight, UV rays, family history, a higher age of the patient, susceptibility will be there. Then specifically genes, if you have to speak of, now you have to talk about these two. These are the proto-oncogenes which are getting mutated, and the tumor suppressor which is getting mutated is this one. Okay. So growth factor, fibroblast growth factor, the proto-oncogene INT2. Okay. So this can get amplified. So the growth factor is amplified, right? Obviously the growth factor is getting what? The growth factor is getting amplified. The growth factor is getting amplified. That is the cause of the malignant melanoma. It's a proto-oncogene associated human tumor. So many other melanoma is also listed here. Then melanoma, even the cyclin dependent kinase CDK4 also can get amplified or mutated. Amplified. Remember, all these are amplified. Okay. What about the tumor suppressor? Tumor suppressor gets suppressed. Which is the tumor suppressor that gets suppressed? P16 INK4A gene. If you want, you can remember all these names to get marks. Okay. At least remember, some growth factors are more, cyclin dependent kinases, CDK4s are more. Some tumor suppressor is suppressed. Remember, it is not P53, it is P16 here. Okay. So about the genes you have learned. Now clinically how it appears, you have seen it appears as a flat or slightly elevated nevus which has variegated pigmentation. You have seen the colors are varying a lot. Irregular borders and has secondary changes which can be there, like ulceration, bleeding, increasing size. Okay. So secondary changes can be there. Okay. All these usually appear de novo. De novo means these are all new moles, like they were not there before, kind of a thing. That is when people have to become alert. Whenever there is something that is new, it was not there, or the size is increasing, something is changing, that is when it indicates a malignancy. Benign conditions, usually they are there from the time I'm born, don't bother about it. Okay, that is different, okay? So guys, you are understanding the concept, right? A mole that has always been there, don't bother. A mole that is new, a mole that is changing, a mole that is color is varying, something is different. These are the things that you have to worry about. These are the worrisome things, okay? Now, the dermatologists have this ABCDE, okay, acronym. A is for asymmetry. You can see asymmetry here. Border is irregular, that is B. C is for color change. Diameter is greater than 6 millimeter. Guys, pay attention here. You can see here the diameter is greater than 6 millimeter. Evolution and elevation is speaking about E. So, what is A, guys? A is asymmetry, border irregular, color change, diameter greater than 6 millimeter, E is evolution and elevation. So, if it is evolving, that means something is changing, evolving, that is when you have to be alert, right? Elevated also can give some clue. Now, the differences between a benign and a malignant condition. Benign, basically you have to use that word nevus, right? And malignant, you can use the word melanoma. So, clinical features, you will write ABCDE, diameter greater than 6 millimeter. Location. Location, we already told you, usually it will be in the trunk and the leg, right? It can also be in the oral and the genital tract, etc. Even the bowel, they are saying. This nevus will usually be there on the face and the mucosa. Histopathology, they are saying there are nests of cells in nevus. In malignant melanoma, there will be various patterns, so many patterns will be there. Solid sheet pattern will be there. Alveoli is there, nests are there, islands are there. I think we have to look at this in a microscopy. So various patterns are there in malignant melanoma. What about the cells? Cells in benign condition, uniform looking cells. However, in malignancy, there will be malignant cells, ATPR, mitosis, nucleolides are prominent, etc. Right? So those are the typical things that you write about any malignant condition. Look at the other differences, guys. Melanin pigment. Melanin pigment is irregular, close, coarse clumps. But in malignant condition, the melanin pigment, they are saying, is fine granules uniformly distributed. Interesting. Fine granules uniformly distributed, they are saying. But the pigmentation will be irregular only. What about inflammation? Inflammation is often present in malignant condition. Interesting. Malignant condition has inflammation. Inflammation is present. Why isn't it making it red? Okay. So, inflammation often is present in malignant condition. Okay. Pigment is fine granules. See, irregular pigmentation, yes, but the pigment has fine granules and uniformly distributed. But the pigmentation or color varies, okay? The spread. This one actually doesn't spread. A nevus or a N-A-E-V-U-S, whatever you want to pronounce it as, it does not spread. It remains confined. It's only a, probably a cosmetic problem, that's all. But malignant condition, they spread hematogenously. That is via blood they spread. Even by lymphatics, they can spread, okay? So it is a metastatic condition. It's a malignant condition. Right? It can invade, infiltrate and metastasize. So those were the differences between the nevus and a melanoma. Let's move on to the gross. Gross of malignant melanoma, there are five types here. Lentigo maligna melanoma, superficial spreading melanoma, acral lentigenous, melanoma, nodular melanoma and desmoplastic melanoma. If you want to look at these details, then you have to watch now. We also have to look at the microscopy, guys. Microscopy, this is how we have drawn in our lab. So you can pay attention here. So all these details we have to look at. There is some junctional activity, melanoma cells, mitotic figures, melanin pigment. So I think we will do one thing. We will take up the gross and the microscopy. We will take up in the next video. Okay, come back for the next video where we will learn the malignant melanoma morphology, that is the gross and the microscopy, in the next video, okay? Now I know you're planning to run away, so just take a recap at least. What you have seen so far. So it's arising from melanocytes. What are we talking about? Malignant melanoma. It's arising from melanocytes. It can be on skin, oral cavity, mucosa, anogenital, esophagus, conjunctiva, orbit, leptomeninges. Don't forget leptomeninges, okay? Common sites on skin for women are legs, men, it's trunk. It affects people who are white, sun exposed, UV light, family history, right? Age of the patient, write this, growth factors, fibroblast, growth factor. So like INT2, if you want, you can remember official name they are saying is FGF, fibroblast growth factor. It's so easy now, we'll go with that. Fibroblast growth factor. It's easier to remember. FGF, fibroblast growth factor, will be amplified, right? So that will be the gene which causes melanoma. Then cyclin CDK4, that also you'll be able to remember. Cyclin dependent kinase CDK4. Amplification mutation. What about tumor suppressor? It's not P53, it's P16. So you'll be able to write that also in the exam, right? It's not P53, it's P16. Okay? Then, clinically, it will be a new mole, something that is progressing, evolution, etc. All this you will explain, A, B, C, D, E. Then clinical features, differences you have seen. Then we will look at the gross and the microscopy in the next video. See you in the next video, guys. Come back and we'll continue with the pathology, morphology. Okay? Bye-bye.